healthcare sector.
Okay.
If you are trained as a health service worker,
yes,
you know that if you have a service user or somebody that has challenging behavior, yes, whether the person carries a knife or any kind of weapon, your duty at that time is to ensure that they don't harm themselves and they don't harm another person.
Yeah.
That means you cannot hurt them.
Yes.
That means you protect them, yes, even while they are doing it. And our jobs, we have protected their children. We have protected people. I know a lot of people who are down with injuries. Some people got broken hands, broken legs. All this we got from service users. People that we love and work with and protect. They injure us. Some of us have injury for life from working with people with mental health illness. Why should our son be killed because of the same mental health illness? Why should they kill our son and then tag him with a weapon, even in death? Why would they finish our son in death? Even in death, they dishonored him. Even in death, they dishonored his family. He's only a boy that is suffering an illness. They dishonored him. They said all sorts of lies against him. One encounter said that he punctured somebody, he broke somebody's nose. Another one said he broke somebody's teeth. Another one said he had a knife. So he had a knife, and yet he was punching and breaking nose. And yet he was punching and breaking teeth. And he didn't stab anyone. Okay, even if he stabbed someone, couldn't two police officers disarm him? Are they not trained? Ordinary social service worker can disarm a man. Two service workers can disarm a man with challenging behavior. Why should the police that is supposed to protect the Republic of Ireland fail in their duty to disarm one man? 15 men, more than 15 men, I watched the video. Lots of men could not disarm one man. They shot him at the back. They shot him when he was down. Who shoots a man when he is down? In presence of his siblings, and traumatized them for life. And then some godforsaken people come on social media and say that he should have been killed. Can somebody tell me a justification for murder? Give me one reason why I should murder anybody. Give me one reason why the police should murder a human being. What sin can anybody commit that should warrant murder? Can the police officer say that when he was a young boy, he did not commit any sin? Did he not commit any crime? Has he never committed? If that boy was his son, would he kill him? If that boy was his son and he had a knife, would he kill him? No, we are not accepting this. We stand against it. Because if we stand for this, they are going to wipe out all our sons. And our boys come from school. They search them on the road.
Yes.
Unique children, good boys, not fighters, not killers. They walk on the road. Their crime is that they went to school. On their way from school, they stop them, they search them. They ask them stupid questions like, are you on drugs? Am I on drugs because I am black? And when we say it, they say that we are crying racism. Would somebody kill the child of that police officer and then be told that he's crying racism? We are aggrieved. We are aggrieved to our marrows. And we will not stand for this. The Lord forbids that we stand for this. Because if we stand for this, they will wipe us all out. They have started with George. Tomorrow it may be your son. Tomorrow it may be my own. Nobody knows. But we are not standing for this. We refuse to stand for this. Not just